payphone was ringing. Somehow I knew the call was for me.
Hello?
Alan Wake?
Yes.
Do you know who I am?
No. Who is this?
We'll get to that later. There are spies all over. Shadows.
A sense of deja vu washed over me. Had I had this conversation before?
Alan, listen to me carefully. Caldera Street Station, the subway. You need to go there. I'll call you again later. Make sure to pick up.
Do I know you? I know you from somewhere.
You've just forgotten again. We're in this together. Don't worry. I got you now. We've been working great.
I'm losing you. Hello? Hello?
The man had said Caldera Street Station. I had to go there. Missing. I had to make it appear. Maybe I could use the lamp to reveal the station entrance. The lamp was dead in my hand. I needed to find a light for it. Fuck.
Okay, don't mind me, just passing through.
Shadows stirred like there was someone there, but there was no one. I wanted to keep it that way. It was locked from the other side.
Is this the way it was on the page?
What the hell? Oh, hey. We met at Dor's show.
Alan Wake, the writer. I'm Alex Casey. I'm looking into a murder.
Come on, what? What is this?
There's a piece of evidence, a manuscript of a novel. You wouldn't know anything about it?
A manuscript? What manuscript? I need to see it.
Rumor had it the manuscript contained the details of the murders. A murder cult was following the story to commit their gruesome acts. Was Wake their leader? Had he written it? How far would he go to create a perfect work of art? Or would he be the next victim? Stay here.
No, wait! I need a gun!
No chance.
This was an echo of the books I had written for years. Picking up Casey's gun felt like I was assuming the role of the detective. I had a light now. I needed to get back to the subway station entrance. Shit. With the alley in darkness now, restless shadows block my way. To open the subway entrance now.
Hello.
Oh. Hey, Alan. You snuck up on me.
Sorry. Have we met?
Memory problems again, huh? Yeah, we've met. Tim Breaker. We've shared notes. Hey, I've made some progress on the map, if you want to take a look. I still haven't found my mystery man, though.
You're making a map?
Trying to. It's hard to map a dream, though. I keep ending up in unexpected places. I find interesting things like those strange markings that react to the light. But never the one thing that I'm looking for. Feel free to check the map out. Oh, I've been stockpiling supplies while I poke around. If you find a stash, take anything you need.
I appreciate the help. Who's this mystery man?
Oh, it wouldn't be much of a mystery if I knew. All I have is a name. Warland Dorr.
The talk show host?
No. No, that doesn't sound like him. The guy has many disguises, but a talk show host? No. I'll keep looking. Well, that's my crazy wall. I'm just trying to make sense of things. Don't judge me.
I'll trade you walls any day.
Be around, Alan.
There was something hidden here. Light would reveal it. The phrase repeated over and over. The words resonated with meaning. Had I written this?
This is mine!
Let your guard down. You thought you had a team. That you knew what the hell you were doing. Your last mistake.
I had written books about Alex Casey for years. Something lingered here. A line from a half-forgotten story. Thank you. I couldn't get in. I was missing something. Place wouldn't let me go that way. I needed to find another light to go deeper inside. The gates to the platform were closed. I had a ticket. Something about the station platform felt significant. It would work in my writing, but I needed more. Something lingered here. A half-forgotten memory. An echo. Something was here. A vision about to reveal itself. I needed to look at it from the right angle.
An FBI agent had come here before me on the trail of a murder cult. He'd gone missing, presumed dead. The cult was leaving me clues to follow, connecting the dots from one murder to the next, inviting me to
draw an obscene picture on the city map. Caldera Street Station. The name made me think of the exit wound of a bullet.
I had a flash of inspiration. The ghost of my fictional detective. A story thread I could use in my writing. The dark place reacted to my story. The way into the tunnels was no longer blocked. The tracks led into the tunnel. That was my way forward. The Fed had glimpsed into the maw of darkness. It swallowed him whole. It was locked from the other side. The blood trail continued deeper into darkness.
Wake.
Shit.
I don't like the sound of that. It could not be opened on this side. The tunnels were a maze. The blood trail led me on. Another place to use in this story. I needed to search the tunnels for further visions. Inspiration for the story that would lead me deeper. I changed the story, and with that, the dark place changed.
be on this case. The cult can get you anywhere with that black magic shit. Let the day shift handle it. What happened, anyway?
Something.
Another echo lingered here. A source of inspiration.
They say the cult reenacted the murder.
Changing a plot element in a scene without being there was impossible. Add a new element from here. I'd have to go to the scene.
These tunnels for their ritual sacrifices. They say the cult reenacted the murders in Alan Wake's crime books, that Wake was even involved somehow under a false identity. Mr. Scratch, which is, of course, a nickname for the devil himself.
It was disturbing finding myself in the story this way, but I was desperate, and it felt right for the story. I had to be at the scene to see and understand it. Changed the story. And with that, the dark place changed. I could imagine this murder cult performing their macabre acts beyond the collapsed tunnel. The cultists laid the Casey novel onto the altar with reverence. A twisted Bible.
Alan Wake.
I was safe. But the Restless Shadows would return. The water was gone. The way forward was open.
Alan, Tim Breaker, in case you don't remember again.
I know, Tim. I'm remembering more now.
It's good to hear, man.
How's your search for Mr. Dorr going?
It's not great. This dream we're in, putting a lot of roadblocks in my way.
So you think this is a dream?
I'm not ruling it out. You know, my dreams have always been incredibly vivid. They feel real until the second I wake up. You know, in the dreams, I'm often someone else. A different person with a different name, living a different life in a different world. It's alternate realities, maybe. But certain things don't change. Like Dorr.
The sketch you have does look like the Dorr I know. The talk show host.
All I know is the Dorr has something to do with what's happening to me. And he knows that I know. He's like some sadistic mastermind torturing me.
place around me, but so much fades away. Even my memory of the process washed away by dark waves. But some things remain. The darkest, nastiest elements, like the murder site. It's my goal, a stepping stone to travel deeper to escape. Write a narrative that takes me there. Casey will lead me to it.
The train blocked my way forward, but it was here for a reason. It had a role to play. I was sure I had the answer on the plot board. Changing a plot element in a scene without being there was impossible. I should look at the plot board to figure out a way forward. The plot changed the details of the world.
Hello? Anyone there?
Dead. Forward. The cult poured the gasoline over the train car. An iron cage that would soon become a coffin.
Gasoline. Yeah.
Charming.
It turns into a bit of a ghost story after that. They say the dark smoke from the fire still roams the tunnels searching for new victims to devour.
There are no happy endings in this city.
The story thread felt important. I could use it in one of the scenes I'd found. A sick and twisted story. But it worked. The subway car had become a burnt husk. I could get through it now. It was locked from the other side. Something terrible in the scene, but it's what the story needed. I couldn't add a new element from here. I'd have to go to the scene. Shadows were gone, or just out of sight. My path was blocked. I had to find a way through. The lights would help me. The Echoing Hall had a story to tell.
Wake.
city was not real. I was limited to the confines of the dream. It was dark, but the story had to be dark. I had to be at the scene to see and understand it. into place. The story rang true. I was making progress. Taking shape. Red fit the scene. I was sure the plot board had the pieces I needed.
Weak.
I can figure this out on the plot board. Changing a plot element in a scene without being there was impossible.
Wait.
I need to find the answer on the plot board. The hall had changed into the murder cult's hideout. Maybe I had missed something on the plot board.
The Fed had witnessed something here that made him run scared. Whether the summoning ritual had been a bona fide supernatural event or the mass psychosis of stark raving lunatics, it didn't change the facts. The cult was messing with things no one should mess with.
The ritual was a vital part of the story, the key to reaching the murder site.
Shit!
I should look at the plot board. Keep the story moving.
Hidden graffiti signs marked secret routes. I kept hearing whispers around burn barrels of an underground society of mystic outsiders with hidden knowledge. Typical New York.
Shit!
I should work this out on a plot board. Plot changes shape the world around me. couldn't hear the dark presence. It was gone. The tunnel was open now. I could get through. I had seen it before. I remembered now. It was always out there, hunting me. Somehow the victim's heart was the key. Something had shifted. I felt an overwhelming closeness to home.
An FBI agent? Who are you?
What is this? Who are you?
She can hear me.
I'm Saga Anderson, FBI.
We can hear you. This is Alan Wake. I'm trapped here. The dark place. Under Cauldron Lake.
Cauldron Lake? Who are you?
I'm trying to escape. I'm making progress, but I'm in danger. The dark presence. Help me. Please. Help me!
I could sense it. I was closer to home. Had the woman in the vision helped me somehow? Something had changed outside Parliament Tower, where I'd lived with Alice. It was out there, waiting for me.